Welcome to this week's Pascal's China Lens, and this week we're going to answer the question which has been raised the most often for the past 3 years that I've been talking about China, and the question is very simple. Does China care about privacy? Today we're going to talk about a really, really interesting topic. It's about privacy, and a question that is often asked is, do Chinese care about privacy? And many people even claim there's no privacy whatsoever in China. Is that really, really true? A question to be answered. I'm going to separate in three parts. Consumers, do they care? How about companies? And how about the government? What are they doing with the data? Now, if we look at consumers, many people say it's cultural. Chinese citizens, consumers, they don't care that much about their data. They're sharing it. They're very open, not as sensitive as the West, because ultimately it's a collective society more than the individualistic society we have. And there's some truth in that. What it means is if you've lived in China like I have, you constantly have a lot of people around you. And when you have a lot of people around you, you do have people listening into your conversation, and you're getting used to say things which are maybe private, but you don't care as much as in the West. That is true. But do they not care about their data because of that? I don't think that's true. Now, the second thing is that you often hear that Chinese have nothing to hide. They're open, they're honest citizens, and the government knows everything anyway. And so why would they not want to share something that society and government knows already? And that's an interesting debate, because I don't believe that's true. I do believe that Chinese citizens, consumers in general, want to show they are trustworthy, and because of that, saying and claiming they have nothing to hide. But what the government does with the data, or companies do with the data, they do care about it. I mean, the best example is in 2020, when there was the QR health app, the tracing app from China, which was mandatory. You saw that every Chinese on social media, or many of them, were starting to debate what's now going to happen with that data and how does the government going to use that data. Now it's centralized in Beijing. But after pandemic, today, what are they doing with it? And so there's a big debate, and the government has to be very sensitive about what they do with that data, because otherwise they have a big social unrest. So they do care. Now, the third thing that you often hear is the fact that they share or they trade data for convenience. And that's everywhere in the world. I mean, this is no different East or West. We all trade data for convenience and privacy for convenience, or maybe efficiency, or maybe even safety. But China is kind of like ultra convenient, especially when it comes to these tech giants and super apps. So you tend to share more. And so that is true. But when Robin Lee, the founder of Baidu, the Google of China, claimed a couple of years ago that Chinese are not sensitive to sharing their data, they don't care about it because they want more efficiency, man, the whole social media was basically saying, this is completely untrue. We care about our data. We want you to protect our data. We're not just going to share it to everyone. So the netizens, Chinese people online, were not agreeing with what Robin Lee was saying. And so it's kind of like a different perception within China even. So I believe strongly that Chinese consumers, especially educated urban citizens, that they really care more and more about their data than we think so they do. That's not so different from the West. Now, the second thing is companies. Do they care? I mean, when I've lived in China, especially 5 years ago, there was a lot of ads and telephone calls I got, and I was wondering, how do these people get my data? Somebody must have sold it to these companies, and they did. And so 5 years ago, it was like everyday practice that somebody had stolen or sold your data. There were a lot of scams as well, and you got really annoyed with it. But the last 3-4 years, it really became serious, which means that Chinese citizens, when they saw this happening and they knew about it, they boycotted these companies. And some of these companies got really in big trouble. There was a big scam happening or fraud happening with a girl, an 18-year-old girl that wanted to get into university. Xu Yuyu is her name. And ultimately, she paid somebody a lot of money to get into university. The money disappeared. She got a heart attack and she died. I mean, the whole social media was like saying, this has to end. Companies have to be responsible. And I think in 2018, the Facebook drama or tragedy that happened basically in the US Senate, where Cambridge Analytica had given so much data to Facebook, and Mark Zuckerberg at the Senate was saying, yeah, we did something about it, but he wasn't really saying that he did something really wrong and he would change a lot. And he was even saying, you can't regulate us because otherwise these Chinese will just do whatever they want and we won't be competitive against China again. And again, another wrong perception. Chinese companies got really upset, not only because Mark Zuckerberg was claiming China doesn't care, because they actually do care, but on the other hand, also because these companies like Tencent, Alibaba, Meituan, Didi, if they would misuse the data, they could literally lose their license. They could lose their business. They don't want to get that blame. And Li Kaifu, just not so long ago in September, the big AI evangelist in China, he even said at one point that a company called Megvii, one of his invested companies he invested in, that they were using data from Ant Financial and from Meituan, face data, face recognition based databases, to improve their algorithm. After that seminar, and he said it's just 2 months ago, a lot of people online in China were really outraged. And they were saying, this is not okay. What happened is these three companies said, we don't do that. They tried to prove that they didn't. And I really believe they didn't. They don't use that data and share that data amongst them. The risk is too high. And Li Kaifu had to apologize online that he said something wrong. So you see that this is really taking very, very serious in China. It's not about just selling and data on to from one to another. It's really about protecting the data. And so the government, from 2016 on, when there were some high-profile cases, started creating a law or specification, which was called the Personal Information Protection Specification Act, in 2018, 2.5 years ago, where they started crafting all the ways to protect consumers to protect their privacy. And so today, in 2020, this is starting to become a law. So probably this year or next year, this will be a cybersecurity law, which means that any entity that is collecting data, handling data, sharing data, operating data, they all have to take care of that law and they have to protect users' private data. And the interesting part of it is that this law, which will come out very soon and is now being applied as a specification already for 2.5 years, this law is actually being crafted and based on GDPR. And it's stricter than anything you find in the US, from the California Protection Act or any US privacy law. It's stricter than GDPR because on top of the protecting of consumers, you also have a national security aspect to it. And that's very interesting because I believe in the future, any country, and you see that in the US already happening, but also in Europe, they will have to find a balance between protecting consumer data and protecting the countries or protecting the regions. So this is about national security and privacy protection. And that balance need to be found. But it's interesting to see that China will probably be the first country in the world that has a law for both and is balancing those two out. And many countries outside of the West will probably adapt that law because it will fit their mindsets. Now, we'll see what happens. But the only thing we have to remember is that don't believe everything you hear, everything you read, that Chinese don't care about privacy. It's not true. Many people do. Don't believe that the government doesn't care about this privacy. Don't believe they're just collecting in order to use it against people, because people will actually be outraged, and that will create social unrest, which is not good for the government also. And don't believe that companies are not caring about that data in China. It's all false news, but there is some truth that Chinese have given away more data and Chinese companies have gotten more data than anywhere else in the world. And that is something to be concerned of, which everybody understands in China. So I hope I've taken away the myth about the fact that Chinese don't care about privacy and that there's no privacy in China. Actually, consumers care a lot about privacy, many of them. Companies are often afraid to make mistakes when it comes to data privacy, and the government has these strict laws, stricter than GDPR, and might have to even abide according to their own laws, because otherwise they risk social unrest in China. So a very, very different China. A China that, in my view, will not be able to use the lack of privacy as a competitive advantage against the West in a couple of years from now. And that's interesting to watch. Now, I hope you liked this episode and hope to see you next week for another episode of Pascal's China Lens.